You have probably noticed this current track in FL Studio's mixer. But what does it actually do? Today, I'm going to quickly explain why it's there and how it can be useful. The current track is a utility track. It receives the input from whatever track is currently selected. If I select this track, you'll see that it's also mirrored in the current track. Same with this one. And this. So, how can this be useful? Well, personally, I prefer to put visualization tools on the current track, such as spectrum analyzers, isotope tonal balance, etc. Now, whatever track I select, these analyzers will show me what's happening on that particular track. If I select the master channel, it will reflect the whole track, just like it would if I were to place these plugins directly on the master itself. Same with this one. And this. It receives the input from whatever track is currently selected. This way, you won't have to load up the same visualizations on every track. You can also load Edison here, allowing you to quickly record from any track. Do not put any EQ or other processing on this track, though, since anything you put on it will always affect the currently selected track only. I recommend sticking with visualizations, spectrum analyzers, recording plugins, and such. I'd like to thank our Patreons for their ongoing support, and as always, if there's any specific tutorial you'd like us to make, or if you have a question, just let us know in the comments below. Also, make sure to check out the links below if you need feedback on your music, mixing, mastering, and so on. Thanks for watching.